We're all human. We are all different. But how different are we? Is race real? In genetics, biological kinds are differentiated when there is an unbridgeable genetic division between them. Think cats and dogs. Think mongoose and fruit fly. There is genetic variation within each species, but much larger variation between them. On average, genetically, humans, whether African, European, or Native American, are 99.9% similar to one another, much more similar than many other large mammals. There is, of course, some genetic variation among individuals, but that variation doesn't cluster to divide us into distinct races. There is no essential gene that is possessed by one race, but not others. Genetic variation in humans is also, by and large, continuous. People in Western France vary a bit from people in Eastern France, who vary a bit from people in Western Germany, and so on. There is no genetic break between populations that would create races. The pattern of genetic variation is a gradient extending over the entire world. So races cannot be distinguished sharply on the basis of genetics. Yet we see racial difference. Isn't what we see biologically real? True, a small number of genetic traits, such as skin color, hair characteristics, nose shape, and a few proteins vary along racial lines. But genes responsible for these traits don't cluster with other genes for traits that have been historically associated with racial difference, like character, IQ, criminality, or sports ability. Can these non-essential differences between people be used, nevertheless, for medical diagnosis or treatment of disease? Is racial classification medically useful, and does that make race real? There are some statistical differences in health in the United States between African Americans, Asian Americans, and European Americans. For example, Black men and women have twice the risk of fatal coronary heart disease compared with white men and women. But there are also statistical differences correlated with marital status. Married women are 20% less likely than single women to die of a variety of causes, including heart disease, suicide, and cirrhosis of the liver. Married men are 2 or 3 times less likely to die of such causes than single men. So, for medical purposes, racial classification is as real as marital status. There are real differences in risk factors, but they are not purely biological. So why do we classify humans into different races? Is race psychologically real? Think about color. Colors vary continuously, but our minds impose hard boundaries between blue and teal and green. And colors can seem more similar than they really are when we see them as variations of yellow or kinds of orange at the yellow-orange boundary. The same is true of racial boundaries. They are projected onto the world by the mind. Children start projecting racial differences as early as 4 years old. When told a story about a child at school, children remember the classmate's race more often than other characteristics, including their gender. Why do humans do this? We use visible similarities for lots of important decisions: what to eat, where to walk, etc. If this apple is edible, all things that look just like this apple will be. One suggestion is that we use those same psychological, perceptual abilities to sort among humans, too. We instinctively believe that people who share some superficial features tend to behave the same way. We are social animals, so we take features like fashion, but also skin color, to indicate social group membership, and in particular, whether they are friend or foe. Even when you don't know you're doing it, even when you are trying to treat everyone equally, race classification changes how you behave. This is called implicit bias. Sometimes implicit biases show up in harmless ways. Other times, there can be tragic consequences. Implicit bias can lead people to more likely confuse a wallet for a gun when observing a person from a different race and decide to shoot them. So it seems that race matters because of our disposition to classify interacting with social practice. The U.S. Census classifies Americans as Black, White, Asian, Pacific Islander, or American Indian. At one point or another, we have all ticked one of those boxes. Whether or not we want it, race is part of our identity. Racial bias is responsible for immense cruelty, ranging from ridicule to slavery and genocide. Is race real? There are superficial biological differences among individuals, which the mind uses to create classifications, which are sometimes called races. This can impact our behaviors, become institutionalized in social practices to shape our identities, and limit what we can and cannot do.